Good morning, students. Myself Uma Gaikwad. I am from Priyadarshini Bhagwati College of Engineering. Now, today I am going to discuss the topic Newton's rings, which is from the advanced physics subject of B first year semester 2. Now see, Newton's ring generally observed due to the thin film. So first of all, you should know what is the meaning of a thin film. Thin film is nothing but the film. It may be the air film, it may be the liquid material also, but the thickness of the film is very very small, which is almost of the order of the wavelength of visible light. Here you can observe, this is the example of a thin film, which is nothing but it is the soap bubble. Soap bubble, all of you have observed, okay, in the childhood all of you have must play this with this soap bubble. So you can imagine the thickness of the soap bubble is nothing but it is equivalent to the thickness of thin film. Now there are some more examples also. If suppose you will spread oil on the water, you can see the film of oil will form on the surface of this water, and this thin film of oil is generated on the surface of this water surface. Now you can observe this colorful feathers of a peacock, which is also the example of a thin film. Then this is the butterfly, its wings are equivalent to the thin film. Similarly, in mica you must have observed there are the layer of the sheets are observed, and each layer is nothing but it is equivalent to the thin film. That means their thickness is very very small, which is almost equivalent to the wavelength of the visible light. I think you know the range of the visible light, it is from 4000 to 7000. Now there are the various cases in thin films. You can observe this first case, in which you can observe these are two microscopic slides are there, and the thickness is constant over here, whereas the angle between these two slides is 0 degree. Now if suppose at one end of these slides, if you will make them in contact by the rubber band, you can observe there is an angle made by these two slides, which is nothing but it is the theta, and the thickness will not remain constant, because here you can observe the thickness continuously goes on increasing, okay, from 0 to maximum over here. Then this is the third case, which is the important case, because basically it is observed in Newton's rings. Here you can observe that there is a plano-convex lens which is in contact with this glass plate, and the angle theta is continuously goes on increasing from the point of contact. Okay, so you can easily observe at the point of contact thickness is 0, and it continuously goes on increasing towards the left side as well as towards the right side. Now what are the Newton's rings? When a plano convex lens of large focal length is placed on a plain glass plate, a thin film of air is developed between the curved surface of the lens and the plain glass plate. The thickness of the air film is 0 at the point of contact and gradually increases as we move away from the point of contact on either side. This we have just discussed, okay. Here at the point of contact thickness will be 0, and on both the side it goes on increasing. Now when monochromatic light incident normally on the surface of the lens, then the light reflected from the upper surface of the film interference with the light reflected from the lower surface of the film. As a result, alternate dark and bright circular rings will observe. And the phenomena which will takes place, it is nothing but it is the interference. This can be clear from the following diagram. Here you can observe the light is incident from the upper surface, and it will incident on the lower surface of plano convex lens, and again it will transmit and incident on the plain glass plate. So here both rays are coming from two different surfaces, ray 1 and ray 2, and when they will interfere you will get a circular Newton's rings. Now how this experiment will be performed? Okay, first of all, there is a lamp. in our laboratory, I think all of you have performed this practical in the lab of physics, which is nothing but the Newton's rings experiment, in which you use to measure radius of curvature of plano convex lens. Okay, so how this experiment is set up? From this source of a light, the light will emit it, and to obtain the parallel beam of a light, there is a filter or convex lens, and from this convex lens, whatever parallel beam is obtained, it is incident on the plain glass plate, which is inclined by 45 degrees. Why it is inclined by 45 degrees? So that the perpendicularly the light ray will drop on the lens which you want to study. After incidence, you know, the rays will get reflected back, isn't it? So that's why there are two arrowheads are shown. They are incident as well as they are reflected back. And both these reflected rays are nothing but these are the ray 1 and ray 2, which will interfere, and after interference you can observe it by the traveling microscope, because through the naked eye you cannot easily observe. You require this traveling microscope to observe the Newton's rings. So in this manner the rings are formed, and you can see that there is a gap in between this lens as well as the plain glass plate. And which type of a film is there? It is the thin air film in between this gap. So this is the experimental setup. Now such type of a rings you will observe. You can observe carefully. This is the central part, which is having the dark spot, and it consists of the consecutive dark and bright rings. Now what is the optical path difference between these two rays? Optical path difference is given by delta equal to twice of mu t cos r minus lambda by 2. For air it is 1, and for normal incidence we know that angle is nothing but it is cos r equal to 1, because angle will be 0 degree. Now therefore the path difference will be written as twice of a t minus lambda by 2. Now these are the condition for dark bands and bright rings or bright bands. For dark rings, delta should be twice of m plus 1 lambda by 2. For bright rings, it is m lambda, integral multiple of a lambda. All these conditions we have studied already in the 12th standard. For thin film, it will be delta equal to twice m plus 1 lambda by 2, and for bright, it will be m lambda. Now why the rings are circular? Many of you think that why the rings are circular. So the reason behind it is that since the surface of the lens is the plano convex, or it is basically the circular from the lower side, so whatever loci of the film is generated, it will form a circular rings. Then radii of the mth dark ring. This diagram is nothing but it shows you the plano convex lens which are in contact with this plain glass plate. O is the point of a contact which we have taken, whereas the Rm is nothing but it indicates the mth order of the rings. Here various rings you can observe, and if suppose you will consider this mth order ring, the radius is denoted by Rm, whereas thickness for this film is T, and R is called as the radius of curvature. If suppose M is the center of the rings, then R is nothing but it will make a radius of a curvature. And this radius of the ring is nothing but it is equivalent to under root of M lambda R. That means it is related with the radius of curvature by this equation. Now, why the central spot is dark? Central spot is dark because of a pi change during the reflection at glass plate. Similarly, at the point of a contact, both the rays, ray 1 and ray 2, they were interfere destructively, and due to destructive interference, the spot will be the dark. Whereas, in case of a transmitted light, the spot will be bright. Okay, it is not a dark spot. Now what are the applications of Newton's rings? First of all, it is used to determine refractive index of a liquid. It is used to determine wavelength of a sodium light. At the same time, you can determine the surface finish of lenses. it is very important application. Means if suppose you want to check convex lens, concave lens, plane, plano-convex lens, you require this Newton's ring setup by which you can observe whether the surface is plane, whether it is a plano-convex, whether it is a concave, whether it is a convex. Okay, so in this manner Newton's ring experiment is very, very important in the wave optics, and this is very important topic of this particular unit 1, wave optics. Thank you. Hope all of you understood this topic. Okay, thank you.